Welcome, fellow adventurer and dungeon master, to a new edition of Character Concept for You, where I create level 1 characters for you to use as either heroes or NPCs. Feel free to change them in any way you like or create your own hero with the build you see before you. My name is Model 42 and today I want to tell you about Annegret Harmsburg, a human awesome sorcerer that is mainly created as a quest giver, but will also make a very fine addition to your team of heroes. Annegret is a social build with lots of knowledge, but also good spell capabilities for support and damage, and if you want to level up authentically, you should play into her strengths and heritage to get the most potential unlocked. But as with all my characters, you can change anything you want to your liking, so feel free to use this build and character however you desire. This young lady has no class DC, as usual with most spell casters, is of average strength, a bit more agile, quite healthy, very smart and creative, still young and inexperienced, but also a stunning beauty with a charm that transcends her every gesture. She is amazingly talented in deception, diplomacy and performance, almost being as good in arcana, pathfinder society law, legal law, mercantile law, traveling law and society, with the rest being either based on her ability modifiers or some training. On the other hand, her saving throws are average at best, her perception is just basic, though aided by low light vision. She can move normally, has a little more than basic hit points and speaks 4 languages fluently, which are her mother tongue common, Celestial since she is born with heavenly inspiration, Kelishite which is a main language in the area where she is planned to work for the society, and Elven which is often taught for diplomatic purposes. Her armor class is slightly above average and she wears no armor, though at least her attacks have a decent chance to hit, may it be with her dagger or a solid kick to the gut, or deeper. The stars not do a lot of damage, but it hurts nonetheless. Being a human means no special features for Annegret, though she gets low light vision for being of Asima blood, with her having her first ancestry feat being Muse Touched, a lineage feat which she had to choose now or never, and gives her a +1 status bonus for escape attempts, with critical fails being fails instead and successes being critical ones instead, which is a very decent feat. As her skill feat for being a Pathfinder hopeful, she chose additional law, specifying legal law, which makes her trained and upgrades that proficiency on 3rd, 7th and 15th level, making her maybe consider being a barrister later in her career. As a spellcaster she does not gain a class feat, but the whole spellcasting affair and abilities, with access to the divine spell list because of her diabolic bloodline, making her maybe not as pure of an angel as one might think. This means that all her bloodline spells and focus spells either deal 1 additional fire damage per spell level to a target or give her a +1 status bonus to deception for 1 round. She pretty much only uses the 3 basic spellcasting actions, which are casting a spell, sustaining a spell, if it has a variable duration, or using 10 minutes of her time to refocus and gain a focus point back. Nothing else, so let us move on. Annegret has a spell attack roll of +7 and a spell DC of 17, both being maxed for level 1, which makes her an excellent spell caster. She can cast divine spells spontaneously without the need to prepare them in spell slots beforehand in her daily preparations, aside from her cantrips, of which she chooses 5 per day to cast at will. For level 1 she begins with 3 spell slots, and also has a focus pool of 1 to use for Diabolic Edict, which is leveled like a cantrip. This spell can only be done with a single cast of verbal spell action on a willing target in 30 feet, and for 1 round, if it will do the task and accept the offered reward, gains a +1 bonus to all attack rolls and skill checks that are used in that task. If they refused, this will be a -1 penalty on all rolls and checks of the 2 types. Quite a neat spell which will be used as a buff mostly. Her cantrips are her bloodline spell, Produce Flame, which deals decent fire damage, Chill Touch which deals negative damage and can enfeeble or flat-foot targets, depending on if they are living or undead, Divine Lance which deals decent good alignment damage because of her goddess Shellen, No Direction which is useful for any kind of traveler and the light spells, which makes it easier to read and see at night. The Blonde Maiden's level 1 spells are her bloodline spell, Charm, which she can use to make targets friendly or even helpful for 1 hour, Restyle which she can use to change her clothing's texture, pattern, color and minor parts, to achieve the unique look she has on screen, and Sanctuary to protect her from harm during her duties. Since she is of normal strength, she can carry 5 bulk without penalty and a maximum of 10, carrying 1 bulk and 1 light at the moment, with 35 copper and 21 silver pieces in her purse. She has equipped a dagger, a belt pouch, a material component pouch, fine lawyer's clothes, as they seem to hip for a classical barrister, and fine jewelry and stockings. In her belt pouch she has readied a compass, a mirror, a silver symbol of Shellin and a signal whistle, while she is furthermore carrying a backpack, bedroll, rations for a week, a sheath for her dagger, 3 pieces of soap, a water skin, a writing set with 2 instances of extra ink and paper, an ordinary white nightgown, 3 sets of ordinary clothes in white and brown colors, a black raincoat, a white and brown winter fur coat, as well as a fine red and white colored dress. All of those clothes are enhanced to fit her style you can see on screen, making them look better and nicer in quality than they are, unless you are a tailor and know your cloth. Before we look at her interesting personality, a few stats and facts as usual. Anagret is a human with the Arsima heritage, which is uncommon and needs your DM's permission, as does her celestial language. This also gives her the trace human, humanoid, and Arsima. She has the background of a Pathfinder hopeful, right now being a freshly initiated Pathfinder on her first mission, and also is a sorcerer of medium size, that prays to the goddess Shellin, since the young lady loves music and art. Anna, as most friends are allowed to call her, is of lawful good alignment, keeping to laws and traditions as strongly as she can, making amends whenever she has to break the law, and will help anybody in need, if she can. She was born in High Harbor on the Starstone Isles, and is of Taldan ethnicity, being a woman of 16 years. The blonde-haired lady is only 1 meter and 49 centimeters tall, or 4 feet 8 inches, and weighs just about 41 kilograms, or 90 pounds, and is bisexual-minded, not choosing her potential partner or lovers because of gender, but feelings and trust. For her personality I chose 2 points from human, 2 from Arsima, 2 from sorcerer, and added 4 of my own to create a sorcerer to dazzle your group. She strives to achieve greatness for the Pathfinder Society, showing that her talents are not only learned, but can also be useful for the greater good. She cherishes all her relationships, especially friends and her potential partner, with herself not having a family to call her own. As one can see and guess from her abilities, she has a really strong sense of fashion and style, which is traditional, groundbreaking and a bit controversial at the same time. Since she has no family herself, she feels a really strong kinship to orphans and other outcasts who were thrown away and given up by society or blood. Despite her feelings to them, she is highly focused on her career in the society and also is fascinated by her bloodline, which she views with internal pride, hiding it behind an extremely bright and intuitive mind, which is the reason she came as far as she did in such a short time, studying from a really young age in the orphanage she was raised. Looking at her is not only a joy because of her beauty, but when she laughs or smiles in her cute, short and honest way, hearts are going to be melted or stolen in any amount of combination possible, even easier should someone hear her singing, which can be very enchanting during her love for bathing. All in all, no matter what she does, she takes matters of the Pathfinder Society very, and I mean very in every sense of the word, seriously. If you want her complete character sheet, so that you do not need to copy and paste from screen, just hop on over to my Facebook and send me a nice little hello, with the added wish for Anagret. Thank you for sticking with me to the end, and if you like Anna or just want to help out, leave a like and subscribe for more content and guides. You can also leave a comment of what you think about her or how you would use her in your games. Stay safe my friends, and we will see each other somewhere in Galarian.